Okay, before we get too far along, I need to warn you that you will be kicked out of Eden and eternally damned to watch lesser YouTube channels unless you click that subscribe button, hit that little notification bell. So, you better do that now. Okay, on with the show. Originally, I planned this series as a follow-up book to the Antitheist book I published back in 2013, but I decided to go ahead and create this video series instead, which I'll later convert into a book series of books as we go along. Keep an eye out for those. Also, I'll go ahead and put a link to my previous book, Antitheist, in the description below. Give it a look. First, I want to mention that I use the NIV version of the Bible found on BibleGateway.com. Unless there's some rhetorical point I'm trying to make which requires a more ancient version, this is the one I plan to use. It is, of course, the inerrant word of God, so it shouldn't matter which one I use. Now, as we all know, the first couple of chapters of the Bible are all about creation. In this episode, we're going to talk about the book of Genesis, chapter 1, which is a wide-angle view of God creating the heavens and the earth and the creatures, the waters, and then finally, man. Of course, there's nothing evil God monster-like about this, is there? Well, technically, actually, absolutely, yes. It's just hard to see. But if you look, you'll find it. I mean, if this God is real and is responsible for creating all the creatures on earth, then he created a world where an uncountable number, certainly well into the trillions, of creatures who have existed throughout time have had to survive by killing and eating other creatures. Murder, death, kill, murder, death, kill, murder, death, kill, in one form or another since the dawn of time. The perfect opener to the Book of Death. And it's really perfect in its insidiousness. It talks about creation in a manner some people see as divine and beautiful, but there's no mention of how, in order for any and all these creatures to survive, they must partake in the slaughter of, and/or consumption of, the flesh of other animals. I mean, there's this big ball of energy right there in the sky, and an all-knowing, almighty God could have made it to where every creature simply needed to absorb sunlight to live, but no. In all his wisdom and judgment, in this, his perfect creation, we must kill or scavenge on other living things to survive. Wholesale slaughter on a scale which is difficult, if not impossible, to comprehend. Exhibit A, the first piece of damning evidence which I use to justify calling it the evil God monster of Abraham, is Book 1, Chapter 1 of its own story. Some theists may try to equivocate this point and claim creatures didn't need to eat or kill at this point in the story, which makes their argument seem even less plausible. But really, I could let them have that one. Okay, so no animal had to kill to survive when it was all created. But maybe they wanted to argue it wasn't until the fall of man where that changed, and therefore it's man's fault, not God's fault. Fine, done. Now, going on that premise, it's still the work of an evil God monster, but now he's even more cruel than we thought before, because now the creatures God has said are under man's domain have to kill and consume the flesh of each other to live. Because man did something wrong. One man and one woman, in fact. All the other creatures of the earth for all time have to suffer horrible deaths to feed each other, horrible deaths to feed each other, and or have to kill each other to survive. Really. That's not the creation I would think would be born of a peaceful, loving God. Quite the opposite, in fact. That sounds like a world created by someone who enjoys pain and suffering and death. Exactly the type of world the evil God monster would create. Although I will continue to go through the Bible to continue to exemplify my point, this alone I feel is enough. When looked at in the proper perspective, this clearly justifies why I call it the evil God monster of Abraham. In my next episode, we'll examine chapter 2 of the Book of Death, where the evil God monster of Abraham institutionalizes the subjugation and slavery of women. Thank you for watching, and remember, don't get eternally damned to lesser YouTube channels. Click subscribe and hit that little notification bell. Okay, so that's it for the opening episode of my Evil God Monster of Abraham series. What are your thoughts? Agree? Disagree? Let me know in the comments below.